Hi everybody, I'm Lenis. I'm here today because I want to teach you how to treat one problem that I think so almost 80-90% of the people have. I have this problem, so I'm going to teach you how to treat you and it's going to feel much better. I have one problem that is feel pain here between the scapula to the vertebral column. So this pain that I feel here in this side is called the Levetiracy syndrome. So the Levetiracy muscle is a muscle that is in charge of doing this movement, especially this movement. So sometimes when we are doing too many job activity that you are in this posture, this muscle get overstretched and target a trigger point in this area that is very painful, and when it's away you feel like a needles or something that is, you know, painful here, like a somebody have a needle and doing pinching you like that. Sometimes worse, you start feeling numbness here in your arm, numbness in your back, numbness in your neck, and sometimes it's really, really bad, the pain, that you can't move the neck. You wake up and you just can't move the eyes because it's really, really painful. So it's a muscle that when it's a trigger point, it's target, affect everything, all this side of the body. And I have this problem. So as soon as I start to feel the pain, first I breathe and I make sense how is my posture. So sometimes I have my shoulders like that. So I just relax the shoulders first, relax the neck, and I breathe like that. So when I just relax, I feel my shoulders go down. I feel that I don't have a very bad reason to feel stress in this moment. It's just because the activity, or in women because of the bra, or because we use the pulse in one size, the trigger point is target. So just relax, remove everything that in this moment is causing me, even the jacket for winter caused me this problem. So I just release, breathe, and I start, you know, get with my hand, I go and I start trigger the pain here. I trigger here the point and I start to squish the point. So I just squish here, breathe how much I can, you know, hold the pain. When I feel that relax a little bit, I start to move the neck a little bit down and I breathe. Still squishing. Sometimes it's painful, but it's good pain. I move a little bit more and squish. I return, keep squishing, and now I'm gonna rotate the head and still breathing. Remember, this kind is when, you know, you can move the neck, when the pain is not too bad. So it's when, you know, it's starting to feel the pain. So I feel like that. Very good. So I'm going to explain a little bit in Spanish because I know that many Spanish people is looking at me. So en este momento les estoy explicando cómo tratar un problema que es el síndrome del elevador de escápula. Yo lo tengo, mucha gente lo tiene, no saben cómo se llama. Y el problema es que tenemos un músculo aquí que es el elevador de la escápula que se encarga de hacer este movimiento. Y que cuando estamos a toda hora en esta posición, cuando usamos las mujeres el brasier muy apretado, el bolso aquí, la chaqueta de invierno, el estrés, todo esto dispara un dolor en este punto que vas a sentir que te están haciendo con una aguja. Así sientes que te duerme el brazo, la cabeza, y cuando estás bien mal sientes que no puedes ni mover el cuello. Es un dolor horrible. Entonces estoy explicando cómo yo lo trato y me funciona. Cuando lo siento o empiezo a sentir, simplemente busco el punto, lo aprieto, mantengo lo que más pueda aguantar de dolor y empiezo a mover mi cuello, primero en esta posición que yo sienta que estiro el músculo. Ahí lo mantengo 1 o 2 minutos, relajo y luego roto el cuello. Esto cuando no está tan mal y puedo mover mi cuello. manteniendo una respiración profunda y primero siempre, ¿saben? Mirando cómo está mi postura, soltando, viendo que si estoy así, suelto mis hombros, me relajo en un sitio donde yo lo pueda hacer. Ok, so I'm gonna continue in English. I explain everything so fast in Spanish. So, okay, so I tell you this, know how I start to treat the point this one. So when I, for example, I'm working and I need to release the point so fast, I do that I told you. I trigger the point and I just start to move the neck down, rotation the neck and feel it here, you know? That's good. Then I relax a little bit. I move my shoulders back and try to squeeze this pain and feel here. Keep here and relax. Again. Now, again, I'm gonna take the pain here. I'm gonna get that point. A squeeze. And now I'm gonna move the shoulder. So I'm gonna move the shoulder first. Here, crossing here. That I feel stretching, keep holding and squeezing here the point and breathe. Move my shoulder back. Move my shoulder here in abduction. So I try to do all the movements very slow. And when you move and you are squeezing here the point, you feel how the muscle is moved. And is, you know, release this pain, so like that. Move shoulder and breathe, like that. Okay, so after I do this, move my neck, move my shoulder, I'm gonna now stretch a little bit. So I'm gonna stretch my neck, so I'm gonna get here, my hand under my leg or under the chair, and here I'm gonna hold 1, 2 minutes, and relax. Remember always both sides, but sometimes if you are in your job and you need to release the pain so fast, or just the sides, then you work both sides. Then I go here and stay here 1, 2 minutes, and relax and stretch here as well, like that, and relax. So this is the kind of activity that you can do, you know, during your job, or if you are at home and you are busy and you need to release the pain so fast, so you can do it. So the last one that I use for this pain, that now I feel good because I got this pain this morning, I get one ball. It's better use one ball that is hard, like a tennis ball. And usually it's funny because when I finish my job and I'm going home, I take a bath and I get my tennis ball from my bag and I put, you know, I'm sitting in the bath and I put here, place here the tennis ball and I start to do the exercise during, you know, in the bath. So this kind of exercise I try to teach you that you can do anytime and release so fast the pain, because sometimes we say, I don't have time at home, I don't have time in my job. If you are in your car driving as well, you are in the red light, put here your tennis ball and just press the muscle how much you can. And you are gonna release a little bit and feel good and you are gonna avoid the problem worse. So how you do? You just try to find where is the pain, where is the place, and just place here, you know, the ball. So just place, for me it's more easy here, find it. So I just place and I start, yes, okay, got it, the pain. Just move it. I try to move first a little bit back and squeeze. Don't place the ball on the top of the vertebral column, please. No, because it's dangerous. Between the scapula and vertebral column where you feel the pain, that is muscle, that is soft, you are gonna apply. You just push back, try to hold how much you can. Sometimes you feel how the pain radiates. Breathe and relax. You can do this 3 times. Try to hold how much you can, 1, 2 minutes. And then you start like, a, you know, it's a scratching your back with the ball. Moving right down, how much you can. The idea is that use the ball to massage the point like that. It's like when you go to your massage therapist and the massage therapist do this in your muscles. So it's the same. And massage this area. So it's gonna help you. And another thing that you can do is just, you can use lotion or whatever you want, or oil, you can massage this area. So you are gonna get this, you know, the skin like that, and just move like here. Just grab and try to move here and stretch. I like when I do this, for example, put together with this trap. And when I do it, the movement with my arm here, I move my arm and my neck like that. You know, I try to move the shoulder and the neck and the opposite side, in the side that I feel that I'm stretching the muscle, that I'm moving the muscle, that I feel with my hand the muscle moving. So like that, and again here. You can do without lotion. Look, I'm doing, I move my neck. And moving here my shoulder, and believe me, trust me, it's gonna help you a lot. Don't wait that you feel the pain to do it. If you can do it all the time, it's wonderful, but very, very important in the moment that you feel like the needle is starting here feeling, please start the massage, the stretching, everything, and it's gonna help you. In my case, I do. And is wonderful. Always something that I teach you, always listen your body, because inside of you, you are gonna find the solution. So now in Spanish, I'm gonna explain a little bit fast the last of the thing that I explained. So van a tratar de buscar en sus casas una pelotica dura, si es de tenis es la mejor. La van a colocar en contra de la silla y el punto donde les duele. Yo lo hago incluso en el bus cuando voy para mi casa, cuando vengo para el trabajo. Simplemente la pongo y empiezo a hacer la presión primero hacia atrás y a espichar lo más que puedo. Respiro, relajo, lo repito 3 veces y luego empiezo como a rascarme con la pelotica, a masajearme, a buscar todos los movimientos en donde encuentre ese buen dolor que llamamos ahí. Y ahí lo empiezo a hacer hasta que me siento mucho mejor. No pongan nunca la pelota encima de la columna vertebral porque es peligroso. Es en medio de la columna y la escápula donde está suave. En ese punto lo van a hacer. También cojo, sin aceite o con aceite, me cojo el músculo y empiezo a tratar de moverlo hacia adelante, integrando también el trapecio y moviendo el cuello y el brazo y el hombro al mismo tiempo. Que yo sienta que se está estirando, que yo sienta ese dolor bueno, que yo sienta que con la mano el músculo se mueve. De esta manera yo lo trato y me relajo mucho. No esperen a que amanezcan sin poder mover el cuello. Háganlo apenas empiecen a sentir como esa agujita ahí. Háganlo a toda hora, en todo tiempo. Yo aquí trabajando, antes de entrar a ver mis pacientes, lo hago y me relaja muchísimo. So, espero lo practiquen y les sirva de mucho. So, okay, everybody. So, I hope so this video helped you. I just try to teach you the things that I do for me, because I have fibromyalgia. I have a lot of trigger points, tender points in my body. So, I listen to my body and I try to do whatever I feel fine. So I try to teach you, to share you, because it's good that you can do it. So thank you very much. And just let me know in your comments, it is good for you, it is no. And if you have more ideas, why not? Share with us. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.